begin with an ordinary frying pan. Miss Holden, would you care to join me upon the stage? Good afternoon, my dear.
Hello.
If you'd mind stepping one foot in front of the other. Marvellous. Now clench, my dear, clench. Marvellous. Up! Bit of exercise while she's there.
Very good, Edward. Have you ever missed?
No.
Have you got close?
Yes.
I'm tempted to go up there.
Are you?
Oh!
What? What's going on?
You might have to do.
Can I just see if they're real?
Yeah, they are.
Oh my God. We'll just do two, Edward, okay?
Right, can you just make sure not to move?
I'll be sure.
Yeah?
Okay.
Can I have a go, Edward?
No.
Can you stand back a bit more? Near enough.
Honestly, I know what I'm doing. What could possibly go wrong?
Edward, you've never auditioned for me before, have you?
No.
Okay.
Go back a bit to the board a bit.
Let's be honest.
I kind of felt my life going in front of me there.
You nearly killed Simon Cowell.
How much would we have to pay you to throw the knife just a little bit nearer him?
I can see in the next round that David actually could take the place of me. You'd be willing to do that?
Yeah.
In which case, I'm going to say yes.
Hello.
Who are you?
I'm Julian Ellis.
And I'm going to take a risk and say you're a farmer?
How did you guess?
Best of luck.
Can I have a volunteer? David! Yeah, David! David! David!
Me? On the stage? But I'm so terribly shy! I can't go on the stage!
Hey.
Hello. How are you?
So I'm going to tell you a story about a cow called Petunia Rose Malone. The farmer loved her. As Petunia got older,
yes,
it was time to find her a mate.
Need a volunteer? You come up on stage. What's your name?
Amanda.
Amanda.
Yes.
Tell the truth. Is that you?
Yes.
Here I have two boxes. I want you to choose one of the boxes. Now, turn around back to back. I want you to open the box. Inside, you will find plastic bags with different colors. Mm-hmm. I want you to think at one of the colors and take it out. Now, put the blocks on the floor. Open the plastic bag with two ends. and think on the color. Now I want you to count to 10 slowly, and both of us will turn to the audience at the same time. Mm-hmm. Start counting.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Well, wait, start from the beginning.
1, 2, 3.
Slowly.
1, 2.
Yeah, now it's good.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
For this next part, I need some help. Simon, you mind? What I have here is a series of 6 crossbows. Each of these crossbows are aimed at the other one. They're going to trigger each other. And then the last one is aimed at an apple, placed right above my head. Now I'm going to be blindfolded, but I'm going to shoot with my sense of hearing. So what I need for you, when I say Simon, go, stand here like this and ring this bell, please.
Back up, everybody. Back up.
Simon, go.
Why is he ringing the bell?
That's where he's got to hit.
Oh, I see.
Simon's right in the way of that.
Are undone.
That's high because David's tall.
This could go horribly wrong for David.
Kneel down if I were you.
That's a first for a start.
Can you hypnotize someone to be a nice person? Nice person. Someone to be a nice person.
This is the clip they'll use when they know you finally lost your mind.
Well, nothing's happening.
I don't think you can hypnotize everyone.
Just a normal dog.
What happened?
Well, just like a dog with a huge tongue staring at me.
Hello.
Hello.
Right, what's your name?
It's Peter Raj.
I hope Amanda is ready for Peter Raj.
2 years ago, I decided I want to come on the programme to meet Amanda.
Oh.
Do you have a crush on Amanda?
Well, I guess you could call it that if you want to. I wouldn't be afraid for someone to say that, but I like Amanda.
You like older women?
Right, jokes aside, what are you going to do today?
I sort of wrote a song and...
For Amanda?
Yes.
Peter!
This is so romantic.
I think you should sit on the stage and Peter sing it to you.
Oh,
you get a chair. What
a gentleman.
Oh, thanks, David. Excellent. We want to make this moment as special as we can for you, Peter.
Peter. I'll tell you what, Peter's come to life now.
I need some water now.
Oh, you want water?
We got some water for Peter.
Here we go, Peter, Peter, here we go. Don't walk off, it's my glass.
Do it for me, Peter.
Okay.
Come on.
Had to overcome fear just to get this near. Amanda one so dear.
Aww.
Crisscross I appear. Like shooting style. One moment heart to heart. Amanda, remember me, Amanda.
Amanda, she'll remember you, Peter.
Remember me, Amanda.
And
remember
our security.
Time we came together. Can't be everywhere. Friend in a stranger. Stranger still in justice.
And to decker only little, you should use them. Hello. Take my jacket off.
Whatever happens, stay still.
Seriously. Seriously. What do I do? Stand still.
My heart would literally be in my mouth. He's not going to jump over him, is he?
Open your leg and keep your
Open my
open.
Leg?
Yeah.
Please don't hurt our David.
I demonstrated skills. Well, I hope it goes better than that. Simon, this time you're safe. But I do need some help. Alesha, could you please draw me on stage?
Thank you for everything.
Don't worry, you're safe. What I have here is what I like to call crossbow roulette. Let me explain. As you can see, I have five crossbows mounted to this, which are aimed at that wall, which is where I'm going to be standing. Four are aimed to miss me, one is not.
He has amazing eyes, carry on.
And all these crossbows, thank you, by the way, have a string tied to the trigger, which goes to this funnel.
Okay.
They're mixed up, and then they're attached to these levers. We don't know which crossbows go to which lever. This is where you come in. I'm going to give you the option to pick four of these to fire, mm-hmm. any one on your choice, while I'm standing over there. Right. What you do is, you pull the number off, you mm-hmm. throw it on the ground, mm-hmm. and then on my cue, you pull the lever back.
Okay.
Got it?
Yes. Oh, my heart's pounding.
Okay, Alesha.
Anyone.
Look at the numbers.
Yeah.
Pick one and pull the number off.
Number four.
And on my cue, pull the lever on my cue. Ready? Now. You got two at one time there, but that's okay. Okay. Now, you actually only have two more choices since you've already fired two.
Number three.
Look at the levers, and on my cue, pull it when you're ready.
Okay.
Ready? Now.
Do you know what? This is fun. I'm not gonna lie.
Believe me when I say I'm way more nervous than you are. Okay, there's one more left.
Number one.
Okay. On my cue, pull the lever. Ready? Now.
Lord, it is mercy.
When I was growing up, I used to love to pull pranks on my family and friends. Whenever my mom was ironing, I'd grab the iron and do this. I've invented the world's only trained flea. Oh, there he goes. I hit you, son? Oh, sorry. Let me just dry this up for you. No problem. Piece of cake. There you go.
That's my favorite thing ever. Amongst this.
Come on. Just see how you feel at the end of it. She had me fooled.
I'm not doing that.
I'm not doing that.
I'd like to remove my ex.
David.
I just sort of thought, wouldn't it be great to see Simon sat on the chair
yes.
and you doing the dancing? We can make it happen. Come on. David knows. David knows.
In 7 years, we've gone on this gig.
Let's do it. Oh, no.
Play the music. Play the music.
Theatres of London's West End, it's said to be haunted by many ghosts. In 1919, the great Harry Houdini appeared on stage and offered a large cash sum for anyone who could prove the existence of them. Amanda, I'd like you to take this journal in your left hand and I'd like you to come with me.
I'm scared.
Legends have said that spirits departed walk the halls and stores of the theatres of London. It is said to be good luck to see ghosts for a performer. For others, not so much.
You look scared.
Oh my God. Where are we going?
That's under the stage.
Amanda, please take a seat. These photographs are of people who have lived and died over 100 years ago.
I'm kind of creeped out.
Can you hold out your left hand like this? Now, in a moment, I want you to count these photographs face down onto the table, one at a time. When you place them down, you're going to feel a connection to one. When you feel that connection, I want you to stop and to place that photograph face down into this cigar box. Look at the photographs. Each and every one is different, but you were drawn to one and you don't know why.
No.
Open the cigar box and take out the photograph that you chose. Turn it over and read out what it says.
Agatha Turner, 1860.
Before this all began, I gave you a journal that's over 100 years old. Open the page I've bookmarked and read out the paragraph that I've circled in red.
Miss Turner was born in the 1800s. She loved visiting the West End to be entertained. She tragically died in 1860, and her ghost is said to haunt the theatres that she once loved.
Amanda, this moment was always meant to be. Look over your left shoulder.
Oh my God!
Do that.
she switched back to her?
I've had one of those thrown at me before.
Yes, I remember that.
I'm tempted. No.
Come, Simon!
Don't you get up and have knives thrown at you.
Why?
I mean, we're all for this.
I know pain, I know dread. Say, you know what you're doing.
Okay, David, and you.
Guys have gone absolutely crazy.
Where do you want me?
Come on.
Both of us?
Yeah.
Back to back.
Good luck!
Is it better to look or not to look?
What's your name and where are you from?
I'm John Parnell and I'm from Nuneaton in Warwickshire, just the other side of Coventry. So, yeah, it was a good drive down this morning.
So, tell me a little bit about yourself.
Well, I used to have a very stressful career, like a lot of people. I worked with computers all over the UK, 50,000 miles a year, travelling for 20 years.
Oh, bless you.
And I was luckily made redundant and decided to go full-time with my hobby, and I'm going to show you a little bit of that today.
Now, what's the big dream for you now?
To teach the world to hoop.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Take it away.
Thank you.
I was walking through the park with my hoop. Then I saw this guy hooping and my heart broke the loop. His style was so true.
So
I watched to see more. Orbit
around. Good hips, though. Good hips, though.
Yeah, good hips.
Hoop guy, he's my hoop guy.
Hoop guy.
Favorite hoop guy. Oh, how I love his isolations. And he says he loves my gyrations. Hoop guy, my cool hoop guy. Hoop guy, he's my hoop guy.
What a shot!
He's my hoop guy.
Now you sing it and I'll hoop it.
I'm not singing. Look, I don't know how to do this. Show me.
Hoop guy.
I can't get that song out of my head. David, yes or no?
Obviously,